Hello and welcome to South County Spotlight on Frontier Community Access Television. We're in the middle of election season, and in Deerfield, there's a couple of hot races for a selectman. And one of the people who's making a bid for Mark Gilmore's seat for 3 years on the board is a newcomer to Deerfield politics. He's not a newcomer to FCAT because he works here, in full disclosure, as a senior producer, Jon Prosperi.
Thank you, Chris. Thank you for having me.
Welcome to the show. Now, you were recently a host on this show with Martha Barrett, and occasionally Jon will do shows on school issues. But, you know, you're a guy who's had a bird's eye view, literally, of what this board has done for the last, I don't know, year and a half?
2 years.
2 years, and because you run all these meetings. So before we go any further, who is Jon Prosperi? What should people know about you in Deerfield?
So they should know that I'm 25. I've lived here for almost a year. As you said, I've been working and doing all these meetings. And I really love to, I've come to love and appreciate Deerfield, watching it and living here and traveling and visiting here. You know, I love the quiet nature of it. I love the small town. And I love, and I've learned a lot about the politics of it. You know, watching all these meetings, I've learned a lot about how towns operate. I've learned a lot about how government operates. I've learned about how to make projects come along the way. And it's taught me a lot about how those things work, and it's taught me a lot about that I care about that. You know, before then, when I first started doing it, I was like, okay, this is all kind of above my head. Okay, am I really invested in these? But as I saw these things coming along, I would be like, oh, I think that that's a really good thing. Like, I support these issues. Like, when I was watching school budgets come out, I could see which things I really supported. And as I got more invested in issues, I started to care more, and I started to become more involved with them. You know, as I went to more meetings, I would start to chat with people, and I would learn more about the issues. And so kind of where I'm at now is that I feel invested. You know, I'm looking to find a place where I can settle in and do some good, make a difference, you know, make my place in the world. And I really want to do the best that I can for Deerfield, and I think that I can.
Pretty unusual for a 25-year-old person to want to be a town politician or to be a selectman. But before we get to sort of why you're running and some of the issues you're concerned about, where do you come from in the world? You were a journalism major in college, right?
I was actually a philosophy major in college. I studied philosophy, specifically political theory. So that's why I learned a lot about democracy. I learned a lot about, you know, rights and how to make just laws. But I studied all those things in the abstract. I studied them as ideas. And it was when I began to watch all these meetings playing out and I saw the process happening that it became real. Whereas before, I would observe, you know, and I did do some journalism. So I watched kind of, again, from that objective, uninvested standpoint. And I would go through the motions of watching it. But it was really when I started to do it that it became something concrete, that I became invested in, something that I wanted to be a part of.
Let's talk about a couple of specific issues. I actually got an email from a viewer who very much wanted me to ask all the candidates their position on the natural gas pipeline, which is the issue that I think is uppermost in the minds of a lot of people, especially those who are going to be forced to live near this thing if it gets built. Where are you on the natural gas pipeline?
For me, it's not even a question. I am a strong opponent of the pipeline. I strongly support Karen Lanness and the town of Deerfield, who have made a vocal stand against the pipeline, who are filing a lawsuit that could go to the Supreme Court with trying to prevent the pipeline from going into effect. And for me, it's not only about invading our home and about destroying the environment and all these other problems, the questions about Kinder Morgan's ethics. For me, it's about rights. It's about if FERC can override 200 years of legislation that Massachusetts has put into place, the state has, for its entire history, shown that it cares deeply about the environment and has put all sorts of regulations to protect this. And if a federal agency can come in and give a private corporation like Kinder Morgan the right to just upend that for their own, to make profit where we're not even certain where that profit's going, I think that that speaks towards a serious problem. And so I would strongly oppose it for that reason alone, if not for the other reasons that are beyond, you know, beyond counting.
You don't think the town went too far in banning any kind of surveying by Kinder Morgan in this project?
I think that in a fight like this one, you need to be playing a really strategic game. And if they are going to give up ground in something like that, then Kinder Morgan is going to push as much as they can. If they allow them to start surveying, then it won't be long before they start sending in more things. Kinder Morgan has shown themselves to be that kind of corporation. And so I think that Deerfield is making the right move by really opposing them at every opportunity.
Let's talk about the budget a little bit. It's a very intricate document.
Of course.
There are some that feel that maybe the town is using too much free cash, depending too much on certified free cash that comes after the bills are paid at the end of the year. How would you propose the town budget or alter its budgeting process?
So right now the town is in a bunch of trouble because we've had bad budgeting practices in the past and we're trying to make up that ground. And last year was pretty rough. This year I think we're doing a much better job. And hopefully over the next few years we'll be taking some big steps forward. So right now what we need to do is we need to get a plan together. Right now I feel like we're just trying to solve problems as they come down the pipeline. And we really need to adjust our strategy. We need to figure out what our priorities are, what we want to be spending our money on, and how we can cut back in order to fund the projects that we want and still put money away for the long term.
I think the tough part is Deerfield's always been kind of a cash poor town.
Mm-hmm.
Even though it's rich in the terms of the amount of real estate, I mean, and a lot of high priced real estate down here, but the lion's share of the burden goes on the residential taxpayers because mm-hmm. there isn't a huge commercial base. Any ideas on how to loosen that load a little bit?
So I will say first that in a town like Deerfield, I would say that part of the price of living in a town that is less industrial, that has less businesses, and I think that that's something that people like, is that it's quiet, there's lots of farmland, there's lots of open land. The price of that is that taxes will be higher. But I think that one thing that Deerfield really needs to do right now is it needs to start getting some more turnover in property. And right now I feel like we're kind of stuck, kind of a cog in the wheel that's stuck, and I think that that cog is senior housing. Right now we have a lot of elderly people who it might be one, maybe two people living on a large piece of property who don't want to leave town, have lived here for a long time, but are sitting on a piece of property that could be making more income for the town. And once those people have some place to go, if there were to be an option for senior housing where they could stay in town and stay local, then maybe we could start doing other things with that land, hopefully to bring more revenue into the town.
One of the concerns has always been, how do you balance new growth with preserving what makes Deerfield so special, which is the open spaces? That's the constant battle. And of course, you throw the pipeline in the middle of it and it totally turns the whole thing upside down. How do you keep Deerfield rural while still keeping it a place that can make money and create new taxes?
So I think that it comes down to aesthetic and it comes down to planning. So I think that the thing that people love about Deerfield is the downtown, the common, you know, seeing the farmlands, having those big open stretches, and we can keep those things. We just need to plan intelligently with the space that we do have. So we have this big open downtown, but there's a lot of empty storefronts. There's a lot of space that's kind of crooked off in the back in a little corner that we could be doing a lot with.
Yeah, that would require, I think, some new zoning laws, and that's something the selectmen are kind of involved in, but you've got a planning and zoning board to deal with that kind of stuff.
Absolutely, and I trust those people to do those jobs. If I were to be elected to selectman, I would want to sit down and I would want to, first order would be, we need to create a new 5-year plan. We need to know what the town's goals are and we need to start coming up with strategies to get there. Once we get there, if we felt that creating new zoning and planning to get those properties was the right move, then I would want to sit down with those boards and I would want to not tell them how to do that, that's their job and their expertise, but I would want to ask them what they thought we could do to start opening up options like that. And I would want to make that part of our strategy. And I think that if they heard that coming from the select board, we could start getting those plans moving into action.
The vast majority of money any town spends is on education,
Absolutely. Public
schools. And I know that you've been following the Frontier budget very closely. And in full disclosure, you've done some teaching over there, mm-hmm. Substitute teaching and the like. And you have talked to Martha Barrett. But there's also concerns about the elementary school budget and the impact. Over the last couple of years, it would seem those budgets were pretty much in line with what the town wanted. How do you thread that needle and not look like you're anti-education while still keeping the books tight?
So with education, as you said, I follow it very closely, and I'm a huge supporter of Frontier. I've listened to their process over the last 2 years, and Marty has done an excellent job of telling the truth, you know, showing us where the numbers are coming from. Patty is a beast at putting these agendas together. They're thick, they're detailed, there's a million lines, you can see exactly where everything is going. And so I do have questions about some things. I do think that there have been cuts that have been made that were strategic. You know, I see how they're putting teachers into place to fill multiple roles, and I would definitely encourage and support that. The school is downsizing, and so when the new superintendent comes in, I would absolutely encourage her to continue with Marty's plan to continue downsizing.
One of the big issues, I think, is, you know, there's a lot of empty space at Frontier, and they built that school with excess capacity, I think, with the thought that they'd be able to make some money on school choice. And to a degree, it's been successful in that regard. But, I mean, how far can you cut back, I mean, without making part of that building just unusable?
Yeah. Well, right now the school is facing a big problem with the school choice, and charter schools are doing a huge, are taking more money than they're giving, even though Frontier is an excellent district for that. And so I think that they're feeling a little bit of pain as a result of that miscalculation or that issue with the formula that I think that they were hoping to profit from. But dealing with that issue, now that we're in that situation, I would want to talk to the new superintendent to figure out if we could downsize some of the other buildings that we have, the superintendent's building, or maybe in a prolonged discussion start talking about some of the elementary schools. That's a discussion that the region's been having, and I would definitely want to pick that conversation up.
Let's talk a little bit about ideology, because this is an important election, and we were just talking about this before we went on the air. Deerfield has by far the most compelling election this year, because you're going to have two-thirds of the board turn over. Only Carolyn, unless Mark is able to win your race,
of course,
will be left. And so you've got an interesting situation. We've got two young candidates, new guys, new blood, and you've got a couple of members of the old guard Deerfield, and Kippy Camosa and Lenny Gripko. But you are sort of not running in tandem with that. Explain how that dynamic is working.
So Trevor and I have met multiple times. We've talked about how we feel about the issues. We've talked about the things that we think are important. We've talked about the strategies we'd want to pursue if we were to be elected. And we found that there's a lot of things that we have in common. We care about the same things. We care about the schools. We care about preserving the town's beauty and its values. We care about, you know, helping it modernize, helping take it, because right now Deerfield's been kind of stuck for a couple of years. It's been stagnating, and he and I both care about pushing it forward, getting things started again, you know, working on these projects throughout the town, and really hoping to get these things back in motion. And I have an enormous amount of respect for Kip and for Lenny, but we haven't had those same conversations. And I don't know where they stand on those issues. And so it's become very easy for Trevor and I to say, yes, I think that we can work together. Yes, I think that we can get things done. And I really would like to see the two of us get the selectmen's seats. I know Carolyn already. I know that her and I can work together. And after having met with Trevor, I think that we could work together very well, too. I think we could get a lot done.
You mentioned getting moving. Are there specific programs you're thinking of? Are there things that, because I mean, every candidate comes in wanting to change things. I think one of the things that happens sometimes is if you get on a board, you realize you can't change things unilaterally. No matter what you do, you got to get two votes to go
with
you.
Of course.
So what are some of the specific things you want to see done that aren't being done?
So the first thing that I would want to get done is, as I said, the five-year plan. Deerfield's five-year plan, I think, is unquestionably out of date. And modernizing it would be something that I think all the selectmen would be in favor of. We need to get our heads on straight about where we're going. The second thing that I would want to do, the first project that I would want to undertake, is renovating the town common. Right now, we have sidewalks that are really not very consistent. There's a lot of crosswalks. The town common looks a little bit shabby. It could definitely do with a renovation. You know, the town common is a hallmark of Massachusetts towns. And I think that Deerfield is one of the most quintessential small Massachusetts towns. That's one of the things that I love about it. And getting that town common up to snuff is, I think, would be like the pride of Deerfield. I've seen a lot of old pictures. I've seen old postcards of Deerfield, and it was beautiful, you know? And right now, I just don't think that it has that same picturesque value. So I think that if we spent, it wouldn't even be that much money for something that brings people to the center of town and keeps them there. You set up a park bench, you set up a couple tables or something. You can get people that want to come there. You plant flowers. Because right now, when you walk through the center of downtown Deerfield, you can walk there. There's shops. You can stop in by FCAT. But there's nowhere to go and hang out. You get your Subway sandwich, and then you say, well, I guess I'll go back to my car and eat it. When I think that if we had something like that, it would, that's the first step towards building up the town common, giving people someplace to come, and then businesses can then hopefully come as a second or third step later.
I guess you'd be classified as a millennial, right?
Absolutely.
And I know that on the state level, in the state Senate, for example, they're actually having visioning sessions talking about what are the issues of concerns to millennials. As somebody who represents the young guard in Deerfield, what can the town be doing more to encourage more younger people to come to the community?
Well, I think that one thing that the select board could do is they could, once again, speak with the planning and zoning boards to try and bring in or make the town more accessible to college students. Sunderland's done it to great effect, and a lot of the towns that Hadley has a lot more money coming in because these students are coming in and renting apartments. And then once they're there, once it's accessible, there's a lot of people that want to come in. For example, when I first moved here into this region, it was because I had friends who lived in Sunderland, and that brought me into the region because I got to see the area. I hiked Mount Sugarloaf, and I said, this is a place that I could come back to. So I think that would be one easy step to doing that. We need to get more housing available for people on that market right now. I have an apartment, but there's not that many. You know, I really had to hunt for it. Another thing that I think that we can do, the town does a lot of great stuff with having concerts, with having music series. But again, there's not that many places to go. You know, there's Wolfie's, which I'm a huge fan of.
Yeah, you're a big Wolfie's guy. There's the Polish Club.
There's the Polish Club, but the Polish Club, I think, caters to a little bit of an older crowd. You're right, there is Afterworks, and I think that that's definitely a go-to place for the younger crowd. But I think that there needs to be a little bit more of that. There needs to be a place other than a bar. Not that I'm knocking the bar.
Not that you're anti-bar.
Not that I'm knocking the bar. Yeah. But I think that there, you know, like maybe a coffee shop. And I've heard that there was a coffee shop that that went out of business. And
yeah.
So
it was
but I think
that we need cafe, which was sort of a coffee internet kind of a thing.
Yeah,
and it just didn't really.
I think that the cyber cafe trend maybe didn't have enough steam. But I think that we need to start fostering those sorts of businesses that bring people in, because once you're brought in, Deerfield is the sort of place that once you drive through it, you get it. You know, you say, oh, this is a nice place to be. You know, like you walk down the town and it's, you know, it's nice. The people smile and say hi. You know, it's welcoming. It's warm, you know. So I think that once you get people into that environment, it's really easy to make them want to stay if there are places available. So it's kind of solving two parts of that issue need to be fixed. And those are two things that are definitely on my radar. For things that I would want to fix.
Now, how does a selectman convince, say, an internet cafe or maybe someone who wants to run a nightclub to come mm-hmm. to Deerfield? And how do you get away from this feeling that Deerfield has largely been a feeling for years, that Deerfield's sort of a bedroom community, that people go to work and then they come home to Deerfield, mm-hmm. that there isn't necessarily this push for a huge commercial expansion? And there are people that have, you know, for years felt that way. How do mm-hmm. you change their minds on that?
So I definitely wouldn't call it a huge commercial. But I would want to fill some of these empty shops. Market, for example, that's gone out of business. That would be a really nice cafe. Someone can find a way to make that a profitable business front. You know, something like that where people can go. And I think that the selectmen can't obviously bring in a new business or force them to come in, but they can change regulations. They can work with that. And this is stuff that I'm not afraid to admit. I still have a lot of learning to do about what exactly a select board can do in order to foster to those businesses. But I am interested in doing that. I am interested in making changes if we need to in order to bring those people in. But I want to do it in such a way that it's respectful to this small community. I don't want to bring in a Walmart or something. You know, that's not what Deerfield needs. What Deerfield might need is a corner market, since the one went out here, you know, just a small grocery place. And I think that that's something that everyone who lives in town would like, to not have to drive to Hadley or Greenfield in order to get groceries.
I'm surprised that that property hasn't been touched before now. But
yeah.
Let's go back to the five-year plan, because when you talk about a five-year plan, there's different kinds of plans. There is the five-year plan that is sort of like, here's what we want to get done in 5 years. Then there's the capital plan, mm-hmm. which I think there's been some complaints in some areas. The town isn't really preparing enough for its capital needs, specifically an upgrade of the sewer treatment facility is the big one, and the senior mm-hmm. center. How would you have elected, sort of put those ducks in a row?
So those specific issues, I think I would put in terms of urgency. So the wastewater treatment plant seems like we don't have much time left on it. And that's the sort of issue that if you let go for too long, you don't want to see that blow up, you know, of all things. You don't want to see your wastewater blow up. So I'd probably put that as something that needs to be solved within 1 to 2 years. You know, we have to reasonably plan and come up with something that works. We don't want to just put something in place because we have a problem. That's what's gotten us into this situation, and I don't want to see us continuing like that. The senior center is also very important to me. I think that that, again, along with senior housing, making a place where seniors can go to, having some sort of community space, is going to be really important to getting things moving, getting the community moving forward in a project like that. I think would be an important one.
I think that the seniors, I mean, this town is rapidly getting older, it seems mm-hmm. like, and you know, young guys like you, there are not a lot of them moving in here, and I think that I'm sure that's probably going to comfort some people to know that you got seniors in the mind, because that's a really big, it's a really big voting block and a very important part of the population.
Well, I think that's what it's because it is a very big part of the population here. Seniors are an important aspect of Deerfield, and giving them the facilities that they need. I mean, they're taxpayers too, and if I'm going to be a representative of the taxpayers, I need to be looking out for their interests altogether. I support the schools. There's a lot of families. There's a lot of kids here, and I have to look out for the seniors because those are the two populations that we have.
I know that you've been spending a lot of Wednesday nights watching these meetings, and I've been watching the coverage after the fact on YouTube. By the way, you can watch all of our meetings on YouTube, our FCAT media channel. And I sometimes come away from those meetings saying, why would anybody want to sit on that board? It seems like you're going for 3 hours at some points, and there's not a lot being talked about. There's a lot of talk, but not a lot of substance. Is that something you want to change?
Well, hopefully if I were to be elected to the board, the meetings would be slightly shorter. There would be more direct discussion, but that's a chemistry factor, I think. So we'll need to see what the new board looks like. I'm not afraid of spending time talking about issues. I think that we need to talk about them until we come up with an answer. But I think that Deerfield needs to kind of get its head on straight. Right now, we are running only with two, and that makes a big difference. But I have been watching the meetings. I know where we are on many of the issues. And I hope that working with the other board members and the town administrator, we could really, once we have a strategy in place, sit down and plan out exactly where we want to be. And then those meetings should be really quick. We're going through the business. You know, we know what actions we're going to be taking on things. And then we can start to move forward.
One issue that one of your opponents, the incumbent Mark Gilmore, talked about when he was in here was skims. And I know you've been watching this skims thing unwind, as we all have. And there have been some ugly moments. Where do you stand on skims? Do you support the concept? Do you support them staying in Deerfield? Or would you have no problem seeing them go to Wheatley?
So I support skims as more than a concept. I support them in the reality of how they function. I've met Zach. I've worked with Zach. I've seen the ambulance in action. And I see what they do. And I think that it's all great. I support skims doing whatever it takes in order to keep working as it's working. It has a great service. Zach knows what he's doing. And the EMT level of service that they provide is a huge difference above what we had when it was just Deerfield EMS. I think that the South County EMS needs to be under one roof for them to continue functioning at the level that they are now. Split up over a bunch of different locations, they can never be. It hurts their response times. It hurts their ability to communicate. Zach's off by himself. It's not functional. Would I like to see a service where if any location that can offer skims the services that it needs to be at full capacity is a location that I am in support of.
So you don't have a problem if it goes to Wheatley?
If it went to Wheatley, I would be fine with that because Zach feels confident that that building would fulfill his needs. It has the garage that they need. It has the office space that they need. It puts them all under one roof.
You do know that there are a significant number of people in Deerfield who are violently opposed to the idea of this ambulance service leaving.
I do understand that. And if there were to be a location in Deerfield that were to come forward that would fulfill Zach's needs to that extent, then I would feel I would be in support of that location.
Let's talk about technology. You know, you're a big tech guy. We only have a couple minutes left. And I know that around here especially, you're kind of our tech whiz. Is Deerfield doing enough to embrace the technology of today and tomorrow, or are things that the town could do more of with technology?
So I think that Deerfield has actually done a pretty good job. FCAT is pretty up to date. We stay relevant. We're about to get a huge upgrade in our Deerfield system, which is going to be huge. And just wait for that. We're taking it to the next level there.
HD.
It's going to be awesome. All right. So in that regard, I think that we've done a great job. Now that Doug is in the town administrator's office, he's done a lot to move the town office forward technology-wise. He's far more skilled than I am. And has really made a big impact. He's made a big impact in moving the town forward at the town office level. That said, there are still a lot of places where we could be, where we could have more technology involved. I know that the library is looking to get more computers, which FCAT is going to be giving them. We're going to be helping them out there. But technology is one of those weird things that once you catch up, you're still behind. And so it's constantly a race of doing it. It seems like it's only getting, you need to be catching up faster and faster than you were before. You know, before it was 2 years you could have a computer, now it's only one.
What I can figure out is why this town and others in the valley haven't tried to lure tech companies here. I mean, look at where we are. We're right in the sort of the crossroads between Northampton, Amherst, Greenfield, and we got 91. You know, I mean,
takes you right to Boston, takes you right past MIT. We're right. You know, it's a very scholarly area. Massachusetts has always supported education, and I think that educated people tend to support technology and, you know, moving forward, innovating. And I think that the universities do a really great job of that. This area, I think, would be really ripe for something like a technology company. I would absolutely be supportive if a company wanted to move out here and look into that, because I think that technology is a really, really powerful industry, and I think that it would bring a lot of good people into the town.
Final pitch time. You've got about a minute or so left. Look into that camera and tell the people of Deerfield why they should vote for Jon Prosperi for selectman.
Thank you. So hello to the people of Deerfield. I hope to earn your support on May 2nd because I'm going to work for you. I know the issues in the town. I want to make this town into a modern, classic town. I want to uphold the values that you stand for. I want to make the schools, I want to keep the schools as excellent as they are. I want to support the seniors in all of their needs. I want to improve the infrastructure of the town. I want to work with the town leaders to continue bringing this town forward. I want to bring new businesses into the town and revitalize it into what it once was. And most importantly, I want to represent you, the people of Deerfield, and I want to help make this town into the town that you want to see it going forward. So I hope to earn your vote. Thank you.
Election Day is May 2nd in Deerfield. Be sure to get out and vote. My guest has been Jon Prosperi, candidate for Deerfield Selectman. I'm Chris Collins, and that is South County Spotlight. For all of us here at FCAT, have a good day.